Hey, this is Eric from Native Instruments, and I would like to talk to you about the Traktor 3.1 update and all the news that has been happening since we relaunched Traktor Pro 3 at the end of last year. In this video, we're going to talk about the overmapping functionalities of some of our controllers, the standalone mixer capabilities of the Traktor Control S4 MK3, new viewing options in Traktor, the external mixing mode of Traktor, the new file management settings in Traktor, as well as the preferences tooltips. So the first thing I want to talk to you about is the overmapping capability of the Traktor Control S4 MK3, but also our other Traktor controllers, like the S8, the D2 and the S2 MK3. And the overmapping functionality means you can alter the function of single knobs, single buttons, or whatever you find on the controller without destroying the mapping or without the need of going into the MIDI mode. To do this, you would just go to the controller manager, choose your controller, and then you add whatever you want to change. So I could take the key adjust here, click on learn, I apply it to the filter knob of the S4, assign it to my deck A, and then I make sure that the override factory map function is enabled. Now that I have to set up, I can't just move my filter knob, but instead of changing the filter value here, you can see that I'm just changing my key value. The next thing I want to talk about is not really a feature of the Traktor 3.1 update, but it is a firmware update for the S4 MK3. Once you've downloaded the new software and start Traktor with the S4 connected, you will get a little pop-up window which tells you that you have a new firmware available for your S4 controller. That firmware will enable the standalone mixer capabilities of the S4 MK3, which will allow you to use the mixer of the S4 without having a laptop connected. One new feature in Traktor is the preparation view, which is basically a single deck view that you can choose from here in your layout drop-down menu. There's this new preparation layout listed there, and you just click on it and you have one big beautiful deck which allows you to completely focus on just one track and do everything you need to do when it comes to preparation. Set your cue points, adjust your grid, zoom in, zoom out, really focus on just one thing and don't be distracted. The next feature is also layout related, and a lot of you have been asking for this for a very long time. It's parallel waveforms in Traktor. If we go to the parallel layout option here, you can see that I can have now two waveforms on top of each other stacked and look at them. Of course, you can also go a step further and have even four waveforms on top of each other. The next feature I want to talk about is the external mixing mode, which has been added to Traktor in the previous update already. To access it, open the preferences and go to the mixing tab. You will see the external mixing mode options down here, which basically allow you to bypass all of Traktor's internal audio processing. So if you're playing in a club or if you use an external mixer, you can get the cleanest and clearest signal directly out of Traktor. I personally have my limiter enabled here, which is the transparent limiter that has also been added to Traktor in one of the previous updates. If you don't want to use Traktor software limiter, you can turn this off, but then I would suggest that you apply a -3 dB headroom, just to be safe. So now we're going to stay in the preferences and go to the file management settings to look at the next feature, the tag writing mode. So you can have all tags, all metadata written into your music if you have write all tags to files enabled. If you're using external music management software and you don't want Traktor to write anything into your audio files, just turn this completely off or choose the option to only write the custom Traktor tags into your audio. These are tags like the tempo or the hot cues, for example. To show you the last feature that I want to talk about today, let's go to the global section and turn on the tooltips. What we have now is these tooltips for all the options that you have in your preferences. Just hover over them with your mouse and wait till this little window pops up, which is going to explain to you what this setting we're going to do to Traktor. I hope you're as excited about this update as I am. If you want to know more about it, click the link in the description and feel free to comment if you have any questions. That's it from me. Thank you for watching and I see you soon. Bye.